Hello, konnichiwa. Welcome from my humble bedroom in Tokyo, in Japan. I'm here for a work conference, but that does not stop me getting into Eurovision. If you do not know me or new to the channel, my name is Chris. I make content about Eurovision, and today my plan is to listen to the Swiss song. I've heard snippets, but I haven't heard it in full, and I know it's a bit of a journey, or so I've read. So I am looking forward to that and looking forward to seeing how Nemo performs. I mean, this is like skyrocketing up the odds. It's in fifth at the minute as I'm looking at it now, behind Belgium. So let's see how Nemo can do. And also, I seem to remember Thea from Thea and Selena in Austria last year. Thea was very, very excited about this specific song. I'm assuming it was this song because I know that she had something to do with writing it in summer camp in Switzerland last year. So let's see what the hype is about. Let's get into Nemo, who looks like he's in this screenshot in a train. So we will go, and hopefully my audio setup and stuff is not that bad because in general here I don't have the equipment I have at home, so apologies for that. Anyway, into Nemo we go. Let's go find Nemo. Let's bring him back to the start. Full screen. What have you got for us, Nemo? You go away. Ooh, look at that train map to Malmo. Where's he going from? Zurich? Or Bern? Okay, anyway, the song. Oh, I like this already. It gets dramatic straight away. This is definitely different from Switzerland. I like it. It's from Bern. Right? I thought it's Bern, isn't it? Or Basel, isn't it? It's Basel. Anyway. What a voice. And also I can imagine the look that Nemo may be able to bring on stage. This is gonna be okay, yeah, definitely. Very distinctive. Rap? Oh my god. I see the hype. I see the hype. I love the way every train carriage is like a different theme, and you're moving from genre to genre throughout. Opera? Party on a train. Confused Nemo. Someone go find Nemo and help him. Or them. Is Nemo non-binary? Let me know. I'm not 100% sure. In one's code, okay. Smart. Eleventh of May. I love this on the I love this video with all the Eurovision references. Or if he can he or they can bring these okay, I'm gonna go with they. If they can bring these vocals live. Wow, this opera is incredible. So good, so good. I mean, I know opera has not got anything to do with Japan, but for some reason that just screamed like Japan at me with the colors. Okay. This is really an amazing song. I see what the hype is about for sure. And they're back to being a train conductor. Oh, he looks a bit like Ollie there from Ollie Alexander from the UK. Right, so What do we think of Nemo? I don't know if I missed a little bit at the end there, but really looks like Ollie. Okay. Pretty sure that train is going from either Zurich or Basel. That's besides the point, to Malmo. I don't really know how what to say about this. I can see what the hype is about, for sure. It's really unique. It's going to stand out a mile. I mean, they're in semi-final too. You've got another automatic qualifier. Like, that is definitely going to the final, for sure. So now semi-final two is starting to look quite difficult, actually. You've got some quite strong songs there. The song itself goes through so many genres. It's in that respect, I could say it's a little bit like Ireland, with the genre mixing. And yeah, and in the same way as with Ireland, this is a bit more kind of genre mixing that's a bit more friendly, I would say, to the casual listener. Whereas Ireland is more genre bending in a different sense. This is so, I see so many similarities between this and Ireland and so many differences. So first of all, if Nemo is non-binary and Bambi is non-binary, of course we know Bambi is non-binary already, they do the genre swapping. They're non-binary in gender. The style of music is very different from what you would expect. Like, both do rap in a different form as one part of the genre. Bambi shows off their vocals in the kind of the slower part, getting out of the hollow, whereas Nemo shows off the vocals in the operatic part. And yeah, I can see this doing really, really well. This, to be honest, will appeal more to a mainstream audience and probably the casual viewer than Bambi at first listen. Thank God they're in different semis. Simply because it's more friendly to the ears of someone who is not into kind of more rocky music. I would love to like sit down with Nemo and just get a concept of where this song came from. At Zurich, now I see it. It's going from Zurich to Malmo. Okay, this song has potential to do really, really well. It's why Switzerland? Why, when Ireland like sends a risk, when Ireland sends a non-binary alternative artist with alternative like genres of music mixed and melded together, Switzerland, why did you do the same thing but in a different way? Why? We were unique. We were unique until Nemo comes along. No, Nemo looks great. I think this is gonna be one to watch out for in Malmo and see how it goes. Also in the pre-parties, I was scrolling Instagram and I heard Nemo do the operatic part, like a cappella. Not the whole thing, just a snippet, but my word, Nemo can sing. As can Bambi. I gotta stop comparing those two. But for me, this is a very strong contender in Malmö. But we have so many strong contenders, it's I don't see how we can pick a winner right now. There's so many diverse genres, still some songs to come. And yeah, this is gonna be one hell of a show. And compared to last year, I loved last year's show. But compared to last year, the diversity, but also I feel like the music is more upbeat. Diversity in music, I mean, but I feel like the music is more upbeat, kind of more like a party this Eurovision 2024. So I'm really looking forward to that and to seeing The pre-parties and the different performances, how they go down, what the live vocals sound like. Because obviously, Bambi we've heard live, Nemo, this is a music video. What others should we have? Like Aiko, for example, let's take Czech Republic. We have a very good music video with good vocals, and then the live performance let it down. So we could have some examples of that as well. But to conclude on Switzerland and Nemo, I mean, all I can say is great job. Fantastic. I am looking forward to seeing this on the stage. I can't wait to see this on the stage. It's just going to be so much fun. So best of luck to Switzerland, and ho here's hoping that you can bring this colorful, magnificent piece of art to life on the stage in Malmo in May. So thanks for watching, and until the next time, as usual, like, subscribe, join the conversation in the comments below. Keep it respectful. Most everyone generally does. No problem at all with that. I've only had to delete like one or two comments. So I'm good. As long as we're respectful towards each other and also respectful towards the artists, I'm happy. So thanks everyone for tuning in, and I will see you in the next time, probably still from Tokyo because I'm here for a week. And I need to go now because I have a conference to attend and to speak at. So, leaving it on a very positive note, Switzerland, I mean, yeah, this is going to be fun. And this is a contender. I think it's a contender. It's a top 10 contender, if not top 5, and even potentially competing for the win. Although we know Switzerland doesn't tend to do that well in televote overall in the final. Semi-final, okay. But yeah, this is going to be so interesting. Well done, Switzerland. What an effort. And well done, Teja, if you were involved in this as well. Like, incredible. Nice. Okay, guys. Bye from Japan. And until the next time, lots of love. Peace.